Hey everyone, so I just got back from my wild crafter class. I didn't have time to shoot instructional video, but I did do a few short clips of the students making some of the tinctures and salves. I hear we're making a skin salve. I had the students go and harvest the materials ahead of time. We've got yarrow for skin healing, penstemon for skin healing, yarrow and pine needles, which is an antibacterial. Again, yarrow, willow and Solomon seal as an anti-inflammatory, and for a pain reducer, again yarrow, cinquefoil and fireweed. So here they're processing those plants. They're chopping them up and putting them in back in those jars, and we're going to prep them here in a minute. Next thing they do after they chop them up is we're going to bruise them using that mortar and pestle. Once we get everything processed, then we're going to put it into a cooking pot using a Dutch oven. We're going to do it over the campfire. Once we get the materials in the Dutch oven, next thing we do is we're going to pour the oils over it that we're going to use to cook it in. In this case, I used grapeseed oil, and we put enough grapeseed oil in to the Dutch oven to cover the plant material. And then next, we're going to heat that oil up. We got to keep it between 100 and 140 degrees. We don't want to go over 140 degrees, otherwise it cooks out any of the good nutrients or properties in those plants. That's what we're doing here. And then later on, we will add beeswax to that to the consistency of a salve that we can use on our skin. For this particular concoction, we cooked the oils and the plants over the fire for about 24 hours so that we'd be sure to get everything out of those plants that we could possibly use. Once we were done cooking the oils after 24 hours, we strained off the plant material using cheesecloth, so that we could just collect the oil. And then we heated the oil back up to a pretty warm temperature and then added the beeswax to it, and that made it into a salve. So you don't see the finished product here, but we're pretty close. Next, we used stinging nettle and yarrow to make a tincture. Stinging nettle is good for sore joints. Good for allergies. It's also a tonic and detoxifying agent for your whole body. It's really good plant to use. And of course, yarrow, as stated in the last little segment, has a bunch of different uses. So we decided to make a tincture using that. Again, chop up the two plants, bruise them a little bit, and then we'll run them through a percolation method. It's where we take a drinking alcohol, vodka, brandy is usually pretty good to use, and we'll slowly filter it through that plant material. So here she's again bruising the plants, and then now we're putting the plants into this wine bottle. Now we cut off the wine bottle using paracord and of course magic, and then we ran the alcohol through that. And you have to have the alcohol filter through it really slow. You want about one drop every 4 seconds, and then when you're done, should take several hours to run through the plant until you get your tincture complete. Also during class, we made a topical rub using rubbing alcohol and sneezeweed, and another tincture using old man's beard and brandy, which was similar to echinacea. We didn't cover it in this, but if you want to learn how to do all that, come on out to class and I'll show you. That's it for today. Hope you enjoyed watching. Hope you learned something, and really hope that I see you out at class sometime.